Last night, former President Donald Trump once again blasted New York Attorney General Letitia James on Truth Social. Now this time, he went a little further than usual and even linked to a Substack post by Laura Loomer that included the home address belonging to Letitia James. So in the post, Trump wrote the following: "Her fake case against me should be dropped immediately. My financial statements are extremely conservative." So this is the civil case having to do with financial fraud. That's what he's referring to. "And her numbers were way off, including the fact that she undervalued Mar-a-Lago and Doral by millions or billions of dollars. She also didn't reveal the 100% disclaimer clause at the front of the financial statements, and that she sued me after or under the statute that was never used before. Miscarriage of justice and election interference all wrapped up in one." And then he includes that link to a Laura Loomer piece that has all sorts of spurious accusations against the AG, and I'm not gonna get into because she's decided to mix up one person with another person that has a similar name. I mean, it's like a laughable report. So the point is, what she put on Substack included the home address of Letitia James. Now, with that out of the way, I do think it's important to give you an update on what's been happening with the case to begin with. So apparently, in addition to doxing AG Letitia James, a state attorney has asked Judge Arthur Engoron to silence Trump after he interrupted a witness during a heated exchange during his fraud trial. This took place today. Now, what happened? Trump attorneys accused a witness of perjury, and during which an excited Trump interrupted the testimony and drew an objection from attorney for the state, Kevin Wallace. Trump, who has been sitting at the counsel table with his attorneys, Chris Kies and Alina Haba, had a noticeable response when real estate appraiser Doug Larson denied having conversations with Trump Organization controller Jeffrey McConey about the value of Trump's 40 Wall Street property in 2013. Okay, so let's back up a little bit. Remember, this financial fraud case has to do with Trump and the Trump Organization allegedly inflating the value of assets fraudulently in order to obtain insurance and loans from banks. So that fraud would land any of us, if we are proven to have committed that fraud, in prison. Because remember, the one crime that gets taken very seriously in the United States is any crime impacting financial institutions and the elite, okay? Now, Trump doesn't think that he should have to abide by the same laws that you and I have to abide by. In the financial fraud case, the prosecution brought forth this appraiser who was actually listed as the individual who appraised various Trump properties, okay? So Doug Larson is his name. His name appears across 5 years of Donald Trump's financial documents, according to the records that were entered into this civil trial. Larson was cited in Trump Organization documents as an expert at valuing properties like 40 Wall Street, Trump Tower, and an adjoining retail space called Nike Town. Spreadsheets entered as evidence explicitly reference multiple phone calls with Larson between 2013 and 2017. So the prosecutors are like, okay, cool. So this is the appraiser for the properties. He's the one listed in the documents for these Trump properties. So let's have him testify in this case and hear what he has to say. Well, Larson today testified that he never appraised those properties. The former president made an inaudible comment, tapped on the table and conferred with his lawyers. That prompted state attorney Kevin Wallace to ask Judge Engoron to tell Trump to refrain from making comments. "Can the defendant please stop commenting during the witness's testimony?" Wallace said. "I believe extortations, are audible on the side of the courtroom as well." Engoron, though, declined to specifically tell Trump to refrain from commenting, instead saying, "I will ask everyone to be quiet when the witness is testifying." Now, this is the second time that Trump, by the way, has doxed someone in as many, in like recent weeks, basically. So that's the doxing of AG Letitia James' home. And recently also posted the name, photo, and private Instagram account of Judge Arthur Engoron's personal law clerk and claimed that she was Chuck Schumer's girlfriend, which is a lie and completely unfounded. But this is what Trump does. He just engages in like these intimidation tactics because he's committed these crimes and it's all being proven in real time and he just can't stand it. Woz, what do you think?
I think the attorney general, fortunately, I'm pretty sure in New York State, and you guys can check this, is allowed to walk around with a gun. And also, like, you know, she's gonna have a beautifully detailed security. She's gonna be straight in case any Trump jabroni wants to come around and try to give some problems, right? Like, Letitia James is gonna be fine. It's just the idea that a former president is engaging in the tactics of 4chan is kind of just crazy, right? That's just a wild thing to even understand. And, you know, as far as the property and trumping up, if you will, its value, we shouldn't be surprised by that. But you know what I find hilarious, Anna, honestly? Trump's corruption is the gift that keeps on giving. I bet you he could find somebody in Russia or Saudi Arabia or any of the countless people that, you know, he traded favors for during his time in the administration that would give him the money that he says this crap is appraised for. Particularly if he became president again, man. It's kind of crazy how self-perpetuating all of this corruption stuff is.
Oh, totally. And look, Trump was far more brazen in his corruption and far more brazen in directing official government business to Trump properties while simultaneously increasing the cost of stays at his Trump properties when, like, you know, government officials needed to stay at his hotels.
Just blatant palm greasing.
It was just so blatant. Obvious. It was so obvious. Yeah. It was like stealing from American taxpayers by doing that. And everyone's just like, oh, okay, who cares? But I mean, his relationship with the Saudis, Jared Kushner's relationship with them.
That's the most obvious one. We're doing all this Hunter Biden. Oh, Hunter Biden. I'm like, this fool took a job, you know, that he probably didn't deserve in the Ukraine for some private company. Okay, cool. Jared Kushner got security clearance, worked for Donald Trump's administration in an official capacity. He was dealing in foreign affairs, particularly with the Saudis and Israel. And the minute that his administration ended, he got an investment of over $1 billion from Saudi Arabia. And like, what in the hell?
I mean, look, this hasn't been proven, but there are some speculating that Trump might have wanted all of those classified documents in his possession to sell them and make deals with foreign governments, including possibly the Saudis. Look, none of that's been proven, so it would be irresponsible to automatically assume he's guilty of that. But it's part of the reason why I think the prosecution, in regard to his handling of classified and top secret documents, is important. Because what kind of favors did he trade with the Saudis? Aside from providing cover for Mohammed bin Salman when he ordered the assassination and dismemberment of Jamal Khashoggi. Aside from that, what else did he do for them? I think we deserve to know.
Look, there's this stuff, who knows what he did for some of these foreign powers, like God only knows at this point. And again, just, you know, full disclosure, this is bordering on reckless speculation on my part, Anna, but I've talked to music industry friends. As you know, some rappers got pardoned by Donald Trump. I heard those pardons were going for about $1.5 million a pop. Mm-hmm. Like literally.
Does that explain Waka Flocka Flame coming out in support of Trump recently? Like, is he looking for a pardon on something? I don't know. I don't really follow him at all, so I don't know why.
Well, Waka, I think Waka's just a guy that's just bored and likes to have his name in the news. I don't think he's really like, I wonder what Trump's position is on Bibi Netanyahu and Israel. I don't think he's really read up on those talking points yet, Anna.
All right. We shall see.
Hey, thanks for watching that video. We really appreciate it, guys. And we appreciate it if you become members, because that allows us to be independent, honest, progressive, all the things that you don't get from corporate media. And all of that is because of you guys. Hit the join button below and become one of us. Become a Young Turk.